My name is Christina Young. I am a PhD candidate and I study biocrusts. And I'm also the executive director of Science Moab, which is a place-based science engagement nonprofit here in Moab, Utah. So you might have heard of them as cryptogams, cryptogamic soil, biocrusts, biological soil crusts. I'm going to use the word biocrust. What they are is this incredible community of organisms that live on the soil surface in the desert in between plants. Biocrusts really are a whole ecosystem unto themselves. Sometimes the most diversity that you're looking at in a desert landscape is actually existing in the top few centimeters of soil. So they're made up of microscopic things like cyanobacteria and algae and fungi. And then they're also made up of bigger things like desert mosses and lichens. They're called a crust because they really are kind of creating this crust on the soil surface. It's holding the soil in place. And in places that don't have a lot of biocrust, you get a lot of things like dust and, you know, you get a lot of moving soil. Biocrusts are also doing other important things in the ecosystem. They're holding the soil in place. They're providing nutrients like nitrogen to the desert soil and the plants, and they're increasing soil moisture and, you know, giving potentially seedlings like a little micro habitat to grow and germinate in. Biocrusts exist all around the world on every continent, including Antarctica. Crust comes in a lot of different shapes and sizes. And even here on the Colorado Plateau, most places that aren't like active washes or aren't like active sand dunes that are blowing are gonna have crust. It just maybe doesn't look like this like big black bumpy beautiful crust that you've seen in photos when someone told you about biocrust. Their structure is really strong along the soil surface, but not very strong to compressional forces. And so when, you know, you're walking in the desert and you step off the trail and you step on some biocrust, you're really breaking apart the whole integrity, the whole structure of that biocrust. And so you're disrupting the ecosystem in kind of a big way. And in general, it's going to be multiple years. Even one footprint is going to be multiple years to recover. And then also, it might look to us like it's recovered, but the functions that the crusts are performing are not necessarily recovered. So they're not maybe producing as much nitrogen as they used to be, or quite as stable as they used to be. But it also extends to bikes. You know, if you're biking off trail, if you're driving off trail, grazing can have pretty big impacts on biocrusts. So those are kind of the physical things that are disturbing biocrusts on the landscape. And then human-caused climate change is actually also really disrupting biocrusts. We're seeing in studies that disturbance scales up to have consequences, like all that soil that the crust was holding in place can then get, you know, exposed to the wind and blown away into the Rockies and change the color of snow and, you know, cause the snow to melt faster because now the snow is that Moab red color. Those are some of the consequences that we're seeing. They're beautiful and they're unique and they're something to look at closely and celebrate. You know, get engaged with biocrust first. And then from like knowing them a little bit and understanding them more, like work to protect them. And so by being mindful when you're traveling through the desert, you're part of the solution. You know, you're part of keeping this desert intact and beautiful and in place. And we have all sorts of really interesting interviews with scientists about biocrusts, but about, you know, all sorts of other different topics relevant to understanding this incredible place on the Colorado Plateau. So I encourage anybody to check it out and wants to learn more at sciencemoab.org. You can find everything there.